Lou's gonna kill me if she gets half a chance.
Dear bunny, we're on the team.
Oh, what a shame.
This is from Karen, Dad. It's all my fault she ended up in prison.
What? What do you mean?
Just read it.
Myron, he's dangerous. Oh, yeah, maybe I better talk to Reno. You're all right, but be very careful. Two Woodridge prisoners tried to report Murphy to the governor there. They both found with their necks broken and nobody could prove anything.
Is this
Oh, no.
Come on, Pixie, quit stalling. See this.
A bit harder, Pix.
Good one.
Bloody hell, Pixie.
Look, I just can't concentrate. We'll have to do
it. Yeah, much later.
Do you think they've found Karen yet?
Well, they must have. I'll bet you right now the two of them are whooping it up in that suite.
Oh, I hope so. She's awfully worried Lyle mightn't come.
Oh, come on, love. You watch. Any minute now, she's going to walk through that door a new woman.
Hi, did you get anything out of the PRG lady?
Yeah, somehow I wish I hadn't.
Why? What happened?
What Stan told you was right, love. According to some ex-Woodridge guys, Officer Len Murphy is big trouble.
How bad?
Male version of the freak. Mm. Apparently his wife ran off with another woman about 5 years ago. So he's got it in for lesbians.
That's why he's got it in for the freak. God help us, I hope he doesn't think I'm one. We're still going to set her up for him or are we going to do it in a double whammy?
Nah, one at a time, love. First the freak and then Murphy. I think the two of them together might be a bit hard to handle.
Is there anything I can do or get you?
Look, how long am I expected to wait around while they dispose of Davy's body?
Miss Ferguson, this isn't the time.
My shift finished an hour ago. I've had to stand around while forensic just...
You can leave now.
Yes. I'm sorry.
I'm terribly sorry, Mr. Davies. Miss Ferguson's been badly upset by the whole thing.
I could have stopped her.
Now, Murphy and the freak are working tonight, so we do it before lock-up, okay?
Does it have to be me?
Of course, it's got to be you.
What if I botch it up?
You better
Look
not.
Out, here comes the bent BJ.
Oh, dear.
Good shot. I haven't played pool in years. How about a game?
Something wrong, Mrs. M?
Who was the last person to see Karen Davies today?
I think I was. And I saw her going towards the right suite.
Why? Should have told one of the officers.
Oh, she didn't try to escape, did she? I mean, well, she's all right, isn't she?
No, I'm afraid not. She committed suicide.
Oh. No!
How?
Hanged herself. Would someone help me pack Karen's belongings? Pixie?
Oh, no, I just couldn't.
I'll do it.
My fault, Jude. They could have stopped her.
Forget it, kid. It's not your fault. It's this stinking place.
Yes. She'd have managed it somewhere, sometime. Obviously, the poor woman needed psychiatric treatment.
You bloody hypocrite. Since when did you trouble yourself about people's needs? You sat up there, dishing out extended sentences, knocking back paroles. You never gave a damn what it did to them. Well, you... I'm going to get a bloody good taste of it before you get out of here. If you get out of here.
Silly, isn't it? We cling to photos as if our life depended on them.
Well, they do in a way. It's the memory of happy times that gives us hope.
Yeah. Poor bitch. Funny she'd held on a bit longer.
I should have realised she'd given up.
How were you to know? How were any of us to know?
Oh, there were signs. She was panicking that Lyle wouldn't come once he found out about his son. I was too caught up in prison politics to realise she needed support.
You're not a psychologist. You can't be responsible for the woman's state of mind.
Who else could have got close enough to her to know what she was going through?
It's not your job. The department should have a trained counsellor on duty all the time. Oh, but try and convince them of that.
Well, not going to help her now, is it? The one who does need help is her husband.
Yes.
Do you think Mrs. Reynolds will let me see him? Might do some good.
Might.
I don't think I could bear facing my cell tonight.
Yeah, well, why don't you bunk down in here if the screws say it's all right?
Mm-hmm. Tell you one thing, I'll be buggered if I'll ever get myself in so deep with a bloke.
Oh, don't be silly, Bobby. It doesn't always turn out like that. My parents have been together for years and they still love each other.
Your mum's never been inside. I'd like to see what'd happen if she was.
My dad'd stick by her. I know that much. Don't know how she'd go in a place like this, though. I'd probably care.
Exactly.
Oh, will you two stop it? Look, Karen is dead because she couldn't stand being apart from her lover. Now, it's as simple as that, so let's not argue about it.
Have you heard any more news, Jude?
Well, the police are here. The ambulance have taken Karen away. Myra's gone to the governor's office to give our sympathies to Lyle.
Oh, the poor man.
Well, maybe if he'd come to visit her more often, she'd still be alive.
I just don't understand it. There must be a reason. I'm sure he loved her.
Jude, you don't reckon our stupid trick outside the visiting suite had anything to do with it, do you?
I don't know. I mean, we'll never know, will we?
Forget it. She got over that. It had nothing to do with it.
I hope not. I couldn't stand to think if we had something to do with it.
Oh, Marlene, don't you start.
You know something? I've seen a lot of death in this place over the years. Never prepares you for the next one.
Yes?
Been wondering why you went so easy on me at the last hearing.
I had my reasons.
Like what?
They're personal and had nothing to do with you.
They did. You gave me the chance to get out and see some real friends. I owe you for that.
There's no need.
No one would have paid you to do it. So what was in it for you?
It's in you. Whether you spend 6 months or 6 years in here is of little interest to me. You're a loser. No matter what happens, you'll always finish up back in prison. It's all you're mentally equipped for. So don't patronize me.
Well, I was going to try and talk everyone into giving you a second chance. But you can forget all about that now. And anything else. Oh, yeah, and you can take all your fancy big words too and you can jam them sideways.
Well, there's no way they can tell whether it was an accident or not. There were no witnesses. And judging by the impact, he was going very fast when he hit the tree.
I should have known. I tried to persuade him not to drive himself home last night, but he insisted.
Obviously, he'd made up his mind.
Now the son's lost both of them.
Do you want me to arrange to have some flowers sent to the funeral? Or what do you want written?
Oh, just with deepest sympathy from all the women at Wentworth. Ridiculous, isn't it? Two lives lost. That's all we can say.
And I had to go last night, love.
Oh, okay. Well, when you fall off a horse, the best thing to do is to jump straight back into the saddle.
Oh. Right. It's all on for this afternoon. Murphy's on split shift and won't be until later. Ferguson's here all day.
What are you talking about?
Plan to get the freak.
God, Murray, you're not going to do it now. Not today.
It's all set up. Why not?
For God's sake, Karen's hardly cold yet. Show a little respect.
Look, mooning around the place and feeling miserable is not going to bring Karen back, and it's not going to help us. Getting rid of the freak will. Now, I say it's on. Any questions? Marley? Good. Stick close. I'll give you the nod when the time comes.
Oh, gosh, I'm glad I'm not top dog. I could never be that hard.
It's all right for her. She doesn't have to face the music.
I wonder what finally did push her over the edge.
Who knows?
The state the poor woman must have been in. I mean, it would have only taken the wrong word at the wrong time.
Yes, well, look, it's happened. It's over and done with. Let the pathologists do the post-mortem. We've got a prison to run.
Only she'd waited another hour. She'd still be alive today, and so would her husband.
No point dwelling on it. It's not the first suicide we've had in here, and it certainly won't be the last.
Not the suicide itself. It's the futile waste behind it.
Good morning. Look, I heard about Karen and her husband. I should have been able to help her, eh? It's not much good at helping anybody.
Could have you done?
Could have told her that when you love someone, that you trust them as well.
Desmond, Bryant, Keane, Greenway, Mitchell, Mason and Warren to the laundry. Right, Officer Slattery, move them out.
Miss Ferguson, do you think it's all right if Sam here sees the governor this morning?
Oh, Mother Hen found herself a new chick, has she? What's the matter, Greenway? Cat got your tongue?
No, Miss Ferguson, it's just that Judy thought
she's got a little few personal problems here. She asked me if I'd come along and explain to the governor.
You've turned into a real little prisoner's aid group all on your own, haven't you, Bryant? See what I can do. Move out.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Okay, the rest of you, move it out. Come on, hurry up.
It's not
acne,
it's just a couple of
pimples. Spare me a minute, Myra. Please. Listen, I want to explain that when I was the visiting justice, it was just a job.
A job that paid very well, as it turned out.
There was never anything personal in the decisions I handed down. I just had to rely on the facts.
Facts that really showed the truth.
How was I to know that? I didn't know the women.
You should have bloody found out a bit more about them before you handed down those sentences.
It was hardly possible under the circumstances.
Under the circumstances? You are very lucky that I've been able to keep them under control.
How long can I expect the stupidity to go on?
Oh, I'd relax and enjoy it if I were you. I think the women have got some very special plans for you.
Oh, good morning.
Good morning, Meg. I just came in to have a word with Phil. Catch the man in action, so to speak.
I'll get him for you.
Look, I'm really sorry about the other night. It was a lousy trick, but I was genuinely trying to help.
I know.
The offer's always open if you feel the need to talk to someone.
Thanks, Chris, but I think I'm getting things under control.
Good. Can I see you again?
Well, be hard to avoid if you and Philip are such good friends. Be seeing you.
I can certainly lodge your appeal with the department and they'll arrange for your legal representation.
Do you think it'll be long before I hear?
Oh, I can't answer that. Depends how many cases are before the courts. Now, as far as locating your natural parents is concerned, we can apply for information from the welfare department straight away. You'd have to give me written authority and state your date and place of birth. Do you know that?
Yes, I'll do that straight away. Thanks, Mrs. Reynolds.
Is there any chance of her getting study release so she can go on with her R course?
Oh, I'd have to put that to the department too. Of course, you'd have to prove that you were cooperative and trustworthy.
God.
So don't expect an overnight decision. In the meantime, I can talk to Mr. Cleary and see if we can find somewhere for you to paint and get in some art materials.
Oh, that would be wonderful. Thanks.
See, I told you she wasn't an ogre.
Well, only some of the time. Mrs. Slattery, would you wait outside with Greenway, please? I want to have a quick word with Bryant before you take them back. What's the Sarah Higgins situation?
She's alive, if that's what you mean.
I'm relying on you and Desmond to make sure it stays that way.
Mrs. Reynolds, you know that I don't agree with violence in any form. Now, what Myra does is an entirely different matter. I won't be held responsible for her actions. Can I go?
Yes.
And you think guilt might have aided him to suicide?
Looks like it.
The number of emotional disturbances that are directly attributed to guilt. This place must be a hotbed of it.
Well, not as much as you might think. I mean, most of the women here claim innocence, victims of circumstance, routine, or they took a chance and got caught.
Oh, come on, that's a cop-out. They're justifying their guilt.
Not always.
Tell you something, this would be an ideal place for study and research. It's a controlled environment. There's no outside interference.
These are people in here, not cases.
Yeah, of course. Look, could you arrange for me to have a quick tour of the place?
Cause you're me mate. I'll use my considerable influence and see what I can arrange.
Good.
So all I have to do is give them my birth details and the welfare department do the rest.
Oh, that's wonderful news, Samantha.
Does that mean you find out about your mum straight away?
Yeah, well, I hope so.
You will, no worries.
I'm glad none of you are worried. How does it feel?
Oh, shut up, Rabbit. Things aren't so bad for you.
Oh, yeah, you're not the one in the hot seat. Luke Kelly gets out today and she swore to get me.
She's not going to get anyone, so forget it.
Country.
I just wanted to let you know I'm not into drugs. Well, I'm not a drug pusher and I never have been. I just wanted to let you know.
I believe her. You know, it wouldn't hurt to give her a go, Myra. You could use a few more supporters around here.
Same coloured walls. Same coloured faces. See, the old place hasn't changed. Now bet on it, Kelly. We've had an addition to the staff since you went on your little holiday.
If you're talking about Officer Murphy, I've already had the pleasure.
You think I get a bit rough sometimes? Wait till you see him in action. Oh, he makes me look like little Mary Sunshine.
Terrific.
Yeah, he should take to you, Kelly. But with what, eh? That's the question. So in the interest of continuing harmony, I think we should work together to get rid of him.
Causing you a few problems, is he?
Let's just say we'd all be better off without him.
All right, stop beating about the bush. What's the scam?
Well, I think we should arrange to have you beaten up. Well, not too badly, of course, just so it looks good. Then I can arrange for him to take the blame. He'll be out of here before the ink is dry on his transfer.
Oh? And just who did you have in mind to do the job on me?
Forget it. Think it over. I could make it worth your while.
No way.
Well, I could put you in a position where he'd get at you anyway. So best to do it my way and get some benefit from it, eh?
What's that bitch doing in here?
Oh, she got careless. She got caught accepting bribes and arranging early releases.
What about using her as bait for your trap? You wouldn't have to dirty your hands at all. All you gotta do is make sure that you're close enough to hear. Don't make it too obvious. As far as setups go, Lynn Murphy is no rookie.
Hey, you're gonna be careless, aren't you? I could have been a screw.
Yeah, but you weren't. Give me some credit, will you?
You gonna go through with this today?
Thought I made that clear.
Company!
Responsible not only for all the laundry, but they take in outside contracts as well. Good morning, ladies.
Morning. Morning.
This is Mr. Sutton. He's a friend of Mr. Carey's.
Hi.
G'day, Mr. Sutton.
Good morning.
You gonna work here in the prison too?
No, this is just a quick guided tour.
Oh, what a shame.
Do you all work here all the time?
Oh, yeah, well, I couldn't do without me. I can fold 40 of these in under a minute. How about that?
Really?
Yeah, you don't believe me, do you? Bet your pipe can.
Warren, that's enough, thanks. Back to work, ladies. You're good to go. Still got a lot of ground to cover.
Bye, Mr. Sutton. Bye.
Good morning.
Jeez, what a punk.
Hi. Remember me?
No. I don't think so.
Well, I remember you. Higgins, isn't it?
Yes, that's right.
Kelly. Louise Kelly. Name ring a bell?
No.
I was hauled in front of you 3 times.
I'm sorry. I don't remember all the names and faces.
We all looked the same to you, did we? Nothing but file numbers that kept you away from your game of golf or your afternoon tea parties. And all the time you were selling your favours to those rich bitches who could afford it. That's why you don't remember me. Because I was one of the poor bastards you never gave a second thought to.
Now, you turn around and walk out of here, or I'll rearrange your face.
So, the 2-rack tart's no cream puff. There are dozens of ways to fix you, Higgins. And I know them all.
Thank you.
Group therapy?
Yes. It'd allow them the opportunity to air their grievances and release aggression in a controlled situation.
God knows, that'd be a blessing.
Well, all I'd need would be a suitable area and the assistance of one of your officers.
Certainly sounds interesting. But knowing the department, I doubt whether they'd part with the money.
Well, that's not a problem. I'm not after payment. I'm just trying to help. I'm quite prepared to offer my services on a voluntary basis, just like Philip.
Well, as a matter of fact, that's changed. The department has at last approved his position.
Oh, good. I know how keen he is. Well, what do you think?
I think it's definitely worth putting to them.
Where's Myra?
Rack off.
Has Myra been in yet? Have you seen Myra?
Oh, poo, what's that funny smell? I think someone's been fertilizing the pot plant. Oh, it's only mad and large.
I have to speak to you.
There's nothing more to say. You can see where you stand.
I never expected it to be easy, but I did expect to be dealing with adults. My initial opinion of you was right. You're nothing more than a pack of stupid, narrow-minded delinquents. And you deserve everything you've got.
Got your jug with you?
Okay, drop it. I said drop it. Now get out of here, Higgins.
That bitch has got to be chopped.
When I say so. Now, anything happens to her and we all face another VJ and an extended sentence. Do you want to give the department that satisfaction?
You're going soft, Desmond.
Try me. Now, scare her if you like. I don't give a damn. But no one. No one lays a finger on her. Understand?
It's bad luck about Davy's husband. But I got no time for people that can't take it.
Well, perhaps not everyone's as strong as you.
Oh, maybe, but no need to drop your bundle. She put herself into Wentworth.
I know that. But there should be somewhere for people like Davies and young Greenway to go instead of mixing with hardened criminals.
Can't see the difference myself. The law's the law. If they want to break it, they've got to cop the consequences.
Well, come off it, Len. Even the courts take extenuating circumstances into account.
Too soft. It's easy for a crim to get up in front of a judge and say it was all a mistake.
Haven't you any compassion at all?
Of course I have. But you have a look at the court list any day and you'll see that most of them are wogs or fairies.
What's that got to do with it?
Everything. Keep the wogs out of the country, lock up all the fairies, and Australia would be a better place to live in.
Well, why stop there? Why don't you lock up everyone who wears jeans or drives a foreign car?
You know, you're a good officer. And you do a good job. But you can't treat prisoners like ordinary people.
Why's that?
You can't afford to be too lenient. If we had a man here for governor, you'd know what I mean.
You don't approve of Mrs. Reynolds, then?
Well, she's a nice lady. Kind, efficient. But she doesn't seem to grasp the need for good, strong discipline the way a bloke would.
And what sort of jobs do you think women officers could do adequately?
Oh, you know, clerical work, typing. You're good at that sort of thing.
You ought to make some suggestions to Mrs. Reynolds. I'm sure she'd be very interested.
I already have.
It's just something I need to take my mind off all the money I'm making. And it might be a good tax dodge. Go on, get out. You know, it's a good thing that I know you're really a soft touch. Hey, there's no need to tell everyone. Sure you won't change your mind about lunch? No way, Jose. I have a date with Veronica and a very nice bottle of red. But you could give my best to Meg.
You got good taste there.
Hey, don't expect an argument from me on that.
I don't. Just let's hope the governor gets in touch soon so I can come and hassle you some more.
See you soon.
Okay, it's time. What's the matter?
What are you doing? Terrified.
Look, come on, you're gonna be fine.
Just keep thinking it's not gonna work. She's gonna see right through me.
Tell you what, I will bet you $1 that she's got her hands on that money within a minute of seeing it.
You're on. You ready?
You get them in a lot of trouble, you know that?
Yeah, got any other ideas? Look, if you don't want to help, just stay out of it, okay?
Right. How'd the book go today, Rabbit? Oh, really good. Must be more money around than we thought. Oh, how much you take in? About $26.
Hang on, Desmond. We'll do a cutlery count on those.
Sure.
From now on, every mealtime we'll do a count the same as Woodridge.
Right. How are you fitting in at Wentworth?
Oh, it's a job. Same as anywhere else.
An officer can have it pretty easy in here if he keeps in with the right people.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, between you and me, we're getting a bit tired of Ferguson. She can't play it straight anymore. How would you like to pick up a piece of her action?
Now, you listen to me, Desmond. I play it straight. Right down the line. You got that?
Yeah.
There'll be no more rackets in Wentworth as long as I'm working here. And Ferguson already knows that.
I don't think you made it clear enough. She's in the cell right now, ripping Warren off.
Trying to keep the top dog between you and the freak, eh?
Paid your mum a visit. She sends her love.
Yeah, I know all about that. Especially what you did to my mum. So don't try leaning on me.
Why shouldn't I? It was your stupid idea that had me facing a murder charge.
You knew what you were getting into. You took the risk.
Have you seen Deirdre? You must have got me message to fix Warren. So how come you didn't?
Because I don't take orders from you.
Oh, you think you're real smart, don't you? Well, I got news for you. You got me into this mess and I'm going to see you pay for it.
You know, you've only got one problem, Lou. Your brain.
And I've got this place sewn up.
Yeah?
Shacking up with Myra won't stop the freak from getting even.
I've fixed that. She won't touch me. I got Alice and Francis in my pocket. And Myra and the girls. They think I've seen the error of my ways.
Oh, so what?
So, I can run drugs, booze, anything I'd like. As long as our precious top dog doesn't find out I'm behind it.
Oh, fat chance. Murphy and the freak will be onto it for sure.
They're too busy playing cat and mouse.
So what's to stop me doing it? Who says I need you?
I do. And you know I've got the money to set it up.
What makes you think I'd trust you after what you did to me?
You ripped off $2,000 of mine, Lou. I'd say that makes us dead square. You better make up your mind whether you're in or not. Or I might just decide to take my offer elsewhere.
We got here.
I wasn't hiding it from you, Miss Ferguson.
Better not be, Warren, because we've got a business arrangement. I don't like people holding out on me.
I wouldn't do that, Miss Ferguson.
It's very good, Warren, because you know what happens to people who cross me.
What's going on here?
Not my fault, Mr. Murphy. Miss Ferguson was making me run a book.
That's rubbish, Warren. I caught you red-handed with this money. Now, you know the rules. You're on a charge.
Forget it. I'll just take this to the governor. You won't get out of this one, Ferguson.
Should have seen the looks the freak and Murphy were giving each other. They would have shriveled anybody human.
How come he let you go?
I don't know, but I couldn't get out of there fast enough. I really thought I was a goner.
Hey, Warren, I still owe you. Remember?
Lay off, Kelly.
Did a good job, love.
Thanks.
Bloody ripper, I reckon.
Yeah, I reckon it's pretty good too.
Well, I'll say one thing for you. You've got a lot of guts. Let's hope the plan works so you can keep them.
You owe me a dollar anyway. I probably had the freak there for a minute before she got me.
All right, I'll take your word for it.
Yeah, you'll be able to spend up real big in the pound.
All right, so I'll get a day or two in solitary. Be worth it to get rid of the freak, though, wouldn't it?
Yeah, as long as she doesn't weasel out of it, as usual.
Well, how can she if Murphy's got it over?
One down and one to go. Trouble is, Murphy's not going to be so easy to fix.
Well, likes to rough people up a bit. Couldn't we get him on an assault charge?
Yeah, indecent assault, maybe.
You lot are dumber than I thought if you think you got rid of Ferguson. When it comes to conniving, she's got tricks no one's even heard of yet.
Yeah, but Murphy saw her with the money in her hand. She can't beat that, can she?
Yep, even the freak could find that hard. Don't bet on it. She started working on dumping Murphy as soon as he got here.
Oh, yeah, how do you know?
Because she tried to ring me in, didn't she? Wanted me to do her dirty work for her, but I told her to shove it.
Funny. Thought you'd do anything to get back into Ferguson's good books.
I don't need her. I never did. And besides, Murphy might have been boss cocky round Woodridge. But that's not here, is it?
You might be right. For once.
Put your money where your mouth is, Warren. I'll put everything I've got on Ferguson to come up smelling like roses. You'll have more than me after you then, won't you?
And I'll make a bet with you, Callie. You lay one finger on my knee, and I'll bet that you end up with a few broken bones.
Are you quite certain Miss Ferguson was dealing with Warren?
Yes, Governor. I heard Officer Ferguson say she had a business arrangement with Warren and expected a cut.
You couldn't have misinterpreted?
Oh, no. Look, I'm sorry, Mrs. Reynolds. I don't like to report a fellow officer, but I can't ignore corruption.
I wouldn't expect you to, Mr. Murphy. Come in, Miss Ferguson. I want you to repeat what you told me a few minutes ago.
Certainly, Governor. I left the dining room after the lunch period and went to patrol the corridors. It was then that I saw Officer Murphy with the prisoner Warren.
Now, just a minute.
Let Miss Ferguson finish, please.
At first, they didn't see me approach. Warren was handing money over to Officer Murphy. He then said, "In future, make sure it's on time." It was apparent to me that he was receiving commission for some sort of illicit business transaction.
You bloody liar.
Mr. Murphy.
Warren saw me then and ran off down the corridor. I was concerned with getting the evidence from Officer Murphy.
Why didn't you?
Officer Murphy became quite physical, Governor. He pushed me against the wall and said that if I didn't forget what I'd seen, he'd hand the money over to you and I would get the blame for it.
That's a pack of lies to save her own skin. My record's clean. There's never been any suggestion of corruption.
So where do we go from here, Governor?
I'm going to question Warren.
Yes, yeah, well, it's my belief that the other women have put her up to this to get rid of two officers.
I'll be the judge of that. Now, do either of you have any objection to my questioning Warren?
Not me, Governor.
Heads I win, tails you lose, eh, Warren? I don't see no future for Marlene the Dill. If the freak don't get her, Big Murphy will.
Ignore her, Rabbit. She's all mouth.
Yeah, but the freak and Murphy won't be.
I'll drop dead, Lou.
Was all excitement? No way. I learned one thing from Warren, though. I've got to keep sweet with Murphy and Ferguson. That way I got to be on the winning team.
Put a plug in at Kelly or I'll do it for you.
Oh, is the big, tough, top dog going to give me a thumping? Shut your trap or I'll do it for you.
Screw.
Warren, you want to buy the governor?
Come on, move it.
Break a leg, Warren.
Lay off, Kelly.
How do you reckon she'll go, Myra?
She'll be okay. Reno's always been fair.
Well, Lou's right about one thing. It's not the governor that Marlene has to be frightened of.
Warren's here, Governor.
Bring her in, please.
Warren? Could you wait outside, please, Mrs. Brown? Come here. Just look at me, Warren. I'm sure you know what this is all about, so I just want you to tell me the truth.
Truth?
You have my word that you won't be in any trouble as long as you tell me the facts.
Sorry, Mrs. Reynolds, I don't know what you're talking about, honestly.
Don't play games with me, Warren. You were seen giving money to an officer. Which one was it?
Money?
You know we're not allowed to have money, Mrs. Reynolds.
There is money amongst the women, whether it's allowed or not. And I'm fully aware that you're running a book.
Yes, I was running a book, but I couldn't have been giving money to anyone. Mrs. Morris took every cent I had.
You've had plenty of time to build up your kitty again.
Yes, but I haven't taken a bet since Mrs. Morris sprung me. I know when I'm beat.
Warren, I know better.
I don't feel well.
Tell me who it was and you can go.
All right. I saw Miss Ferguson fighting with Mr. Murphy over some money, but I didn't have anything to do with it.
He's lying.
I don't want to get anyone in trouble.
You must realize that it's in your own best interest to resolve this now.
I don't know anything, Mrs. Reynolds, honestly.
Is that all you've got to say?
Yes. I think I'm going to be sick.
So, how do you feel about it?
It's done. I just didn't expect a suggestion like that.
Why not?
It just doesn't seem to fit, that's all.
Look, I just want you to meet my parents. It's not as though I'll be seeking their approval or anything.
Well, that might be a good thing.
Come on, they'll love you, Meg.
Well, as long as they don't think that this is a prelude to a wedding.
So? Are you going to answer my question?
Thanks. Yes, I'd very much like to meet your parents.
Good, I'll arrange it. You needn't think this is the end of it.
Really? I think I better go back to work.
Yeah, and I better get my softball gear together.
I wouldn't bother. There'll be no playtime today.
Why not?
I've got the girls for a class after work. Teach them something useful.
Don't try belittling me in front of other people, Murphy.
You haven't seen anything yet.
Oh, use what brains you've got and take it as a warning and mind your own business.
It's my business when someone tries to make me look bent.
That's what you get for setting me up.
I didn't have to. I had you cold.
Then quit while you're ahead.
No way. The department will back me every time. My record's clean.
Then I suggest if you want it to stay like that, you keep out of my way.
Don't you try and bluff me. I've dealt with your sort before.
You might like to think so.
There's one thing I can't stand, it's a crooked officer. And I won't have one in my prison.
You're forgetting something, Murphy. This isn't your prison. Wentworth is mine. And it's gonna stay that way.
What are you up to, Kelly?
Nothing, I've just been in the toot.
You sure?
Yeah, I'd never forget a thing like that.
Don't get smart with me, Kelly. I'll put you on a charge. Now get moving.
Sorry.
Sorry what?
Sorry, sir.
That's better. Well?
There's something you should know.
What?
Look, I don't want to cause any trouble or get myself in strife or nothing,
just
but I just...
get on with it, Kelly.
Okay. Miss Ferguson's got it in for you.
Don't you think I know that? I've worked in more prisons than you've had hot dinners. I know what's going on.
Oh, right. Then you'll know she tried to get me on site to set you up.
How?
Wanted me to cop a bashing and lay it on you.
What are you lagging for?
It's not lagging. She's not one of us. And besides, we've had a gutful of her. I'd rather see her out of here than you.
Makes sense. Is that all?
So far, just thought you ought to know.
So, now I know. You can get back to the laundry.
Just like that?
What do you expect, a good conduct medal?
I just gave you a chance to cover your back. Ought to be something in it for me.
You're just like all the other animals on this side of the bars. Every time you do something for someone, you expect a pat on the head or a good O.
Wouldn't kill you to say thanks.
Thanks. Now get your bum back in that laundry, or I'll charge you for loitering.
Yes, sir.
You what? I couldn't go through with it. I'm scared silly.
Threw the plan out the bloody window.
I couldn't help it, Mara. They were both just there staring at me. Couldn't remember what to say.
All you had to say was what we worked out and the freak would have been out on her ear.
Yeah, well, I know. I just forgot. I was too busy packing it. I thought it was going to be sick all over the gov's office.
Oh, take it. See, Myra?
Serves you right for trusting the gutless tart to carry it through.
Rabbit's not gutless. She did her best.
Yeah, well, it's not good enough, is it?
Best laid plans are nice and men.
Well, take it easy, Myra. She feels bad enough. She's going to feel a lot worse. Look, I don't give a stuff about the plan failing.
Really?
Well, then what are you so uptight about?
I set it up to protect Rabbit from the freak. Now that she hasn't dobbed the freak in, she's got Murphy after her as well.
Well, what are we going to do?
We need to protect her 24 hours a day.
I know Mr. Murphy has an unfortunate manner, but I think he means well.
Unfortunate? He's ignorant, bigoted, and bloody rude.
Now, calm down, Philip. Will it really do so much harm for the women to miss softball and learn how to do a few simple household jobs?
No, but it's only the beginning. Look, I've done a lot of work to get the women interested in softball, and if Murphy has his way, it's all going to go down the drain.
I doubt it. I am still running Wentworth.
Well, I'm glad to hear it.
You may also be glad to hear that the department's finally approved your appointment. You're now on staff, and they're backdating your salary to when you first came here.
Great. That's really great. Look, I'm not going to pretend that the money isn't important, but the real reason I'm at Wentworth is to help the women. If I'm not allowed to do that, then I'd just as soon not be here.
Well, then, it's not the sort of job you could do well, is it?
I'll have to think of something. I'm just going to look.
I'll come with you.
Jude, I can go to the loo by myself, all right?
Someone's got to be with you all the time. You might as well get used to that idea.
Jeez.
Oh.
Jude.
Oh, what do you want?
I just want to talk to you. Don't butt my head off.
I'm sorry. It's just, I'm really worried about Marlene.
Yeah, I know. So am I. Especially lock-up time.
Lost your bodyguard, Warren.
What do you want?
This ain't the fish and chip shop, is it, stupid?
Oh, you can go first if you like.
Oh, I couldn't do that. You were here ahead of me. Wouldn't want me to forget me manners now, would you?
Nah, go ahead. I've gone off the boil.
Oh, what a pity. Good fright helps sometimes.
It's all right. I've changed my mind.
I was surprised to find you in one piece when I got back. Thought you would have copped it by now for fouling up my chances to get out of here. Because of you, I copped an extra 6 charges.
You lay off me. Myra and Jude will get you.
Oh, funny. I don't see them around. And I reckon when they do find you, they'll put the blame on Murphy. Or the freak.
I seem to have run out of prison station. You could have some, please.
Will this be enough, Mrs. Reynolds?
Yes, plenty.
Should have a fresh delivery tomorrow or the day after.
Oh, speaking of deliveries, there's a package here for you. I meant to bring it in before, but I forgot. Sorry.
It's all right.
Go!
What is it?
A dead rat. Bitch.
Where's Warren?
How'd I know?
Don't try and put it over me, Bryant. I want Warren. Where is she?
Well, why don't you leave that kid alone? It wasn't her idea. She just did as she was told.
Where is she?
I don't know.
Oh! You fancy yourself, do you?
Get me out of here, will you?
You perverted bitches are all the same. Always picking on the young girls. I can't stand dykes.
You can't take the competition, can you?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare. They don't mind the stony ground. Christmas too, when morning comes around.